Jesus Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ, in Ascension, sent to the disciples while he was standing before them, "No one has descended except the one who has ascended, the Son of Man who is in heaven." While he was standing before his disciples. So the Lord himself doesn't need ascension because he is in the Father and the Father is in him. By his divinity, he is everywhere. But who needed that ascension? Us. Us. No one has descended. So he descended in Bethlehem to take our humanity, our sins, all our death. And he ascended from the Olive Mountain. Who ascended in the Olive Mountain? We, in him. He at the head of the church, and the church is all of us. He became the head of every one of us, and we all became his members. And he came, took our humanity and lifted it up to heaven. He promised, "Where I will be, you will be." He sat on the right hand side of the Father. We all are on the right hand side of the Father. He was in the bosom of the Father. We became in the embrace and the bosom of the Father. He reconciled us back to the Father. And for that, he made our heads in heaven. Though our feet on earth. So we all now heads in heaven and feet on earth. Can we please see ourselves really living in heaven? When can we feel so? When we think by the mind of Christ, when we love by his heart, when we do his acts. I wanted every one of us to take an exercise, say what Christ will do if he is in my place, and do it. Ask yourself all the time what Christ would do if he is in my place. Do it, please. That is how to live in heaven. That is how to think by the mind of Christ. While he was ascending, the Bible told us he separated from them and started to go up. We know that he separated from the disciples when after he was with them on Thursday, the Last Supper. Then on the Last Supper, he separated from the disciples but to the cross, and left to them all what? Very sad, distorted, feared, yes? And on that occasion, he broke himself and gave it to them. So on the, we celebrate two big Thursdays, the Last Supper and today, both of them Thursdays. One of them, he broke himself and gave himself to them. And the other one, he took us all up to heaven. But when he was separated from them today, the Bible told us they returned back joyful, praising the Lord. So no more sadness, no more tomb, no more death. We all been risen with him and ascended to heaven with him. The other point, that as he is the head of us all and took us up to heaven and made our heads up, our bodies down walking on the earth, he is still suffering for all of us. Suffering for all of us. Can you remember he said, when in the last day I was hungry and you didn't give me food. I was thirsty, you didn't give me water. I was in prison and you didn't come to visit me. I was sick. Means what? Means he shares with us all our suffering. And he takes it personally. If one of the members is suffering, he is suffering. And St. Paul said, if anyone is suffering, I am suffering with him. So if you are in a suffering, be assured that the Lord is sharing it with you, is walking with you in your suffering. He is carrying you. In the footprints, a man was used to see him and the Lord walking with him, with his footsteps by him. When he was suffering, the two feet of the other one disappeared. So he thought that the Lord has actually left him. But the Lord said to him, who do you think these 2 feet? Whose ones these 2 feet? It is mine. During the suffering, I am carrying you. You are my body. I am your head. I feel for you. I love you and thank you. Then he started to go up and up and up till he disappeared, and the disciples kept looking up to heaven and did not look down again. And the angel of the Lord came and said to them, why are you staring up? The one who has gone is coming to come again. So wait for the Lord in his second coming. So we need to kind of summarize it. Head where in heaven. feet on earth. He is, we are his members, member in his body. Fix your eyes upon heaven. Fix your eyes up. You will live up. And wait for the second coming. That is why we watch, and be cautious, for no one knows his hour. And the exercise is what the Lord will do if he is in my place. Ascension has completed our redemption and took us back to the house of exaltation. The house of exaltation. Can you imagine that we are together all living in heaven? God bless you and keep you in heaven. Glory to God.